Welcome to this episode of Trading System Lab. I found a really good strategy via the Candlestick Genetic Evolver. Candlestick Genetic Evolver is really a cool tool. It's basically an evolution on Candlestick. It will create patterns that the normal eye cannot even see. So it makes it really very, very interesting. So what I've done is I opened the Candlestick Evolver. I had my set here. I have basically say my evaluation pattern is on 3 ETFs daily, 10 years. And I say, please find the best pattern for the next bar, profitable pattern, obviously. Another rule I added was to have 200 trades at least. So once you run this genetic algorithm, you'll see it basically is looking for the best combination of whatever you want to find. And so I'm gonna stop it because I did find one already, which then you can save in the pattern library, which is down here. And it actually stores the rules in it. You can see the rules here, which makes it really interesting. And now what do you do with it? You want to trade it or you want to see how did it do? So let's do that. I'm going to close this here and I'm going to open up a building block. Oh, here we go. New strategy by block. And then I go down to the candlestick patterns because I want to use my pattern, not the doji or anything else. I go down to 936 and I want to exit the next bar at market. Sell after N bars, close this, and I say 1, which is the next bar. Let's verify this. 3 ETFs, and I mean, now actually want to test it even from 2000 to 2014, which is basically unseen data for the pattern that I developed. Well, no, I didn't develop it. So let's run it. And here we go. About 3% annual percent return versus 5% on the benchmark. The exposure is only 2.7, let's say 3%, which is really extremely low. And what else we have? We have 512 trades and an average profit percent of 0.47. It's amazing how high the profit is. The maximum drawdown was 9%, as you can see. So this is an extremely good result. Let's take a look at the equity curve. You see, it looks very flat compared to the benchmark, which is the S&P. But it was actually pretty good when the market was going down. You can see that. The drawdown obviously is extremely good. But now, the beauty with WealthLab is that you can actually change or adjust it or use it. And something I did actually was, I was actually saying, what if I hold it for 5 bars, not just 1 bar, because 1 bar maybe is a little bit little. So let's take a look at the equity curve, which looks very flat now. I'm running it now, holding it for 5 bars. And here we go. And all of a sudden, this becomes even a better system or a better strategy than the S&P. This is really interesting because now we do have we have a higher drawdown, obviously, double. Drawdown went up to 20%. We have only 380 trades because we couldn't take the ones where we're still holding a position. And we have 5.5% an annual percent return, which is even better than the S&P. The exposure, on the other hand, is 10%, 5 times more, still way less. 90% of the time we have cash lying around. So we can see actually that this strategy became all of a sudden pretty good, especially also on the unseen data, which is the first 14 years up to here. So it's a pretty good result, I would say. So hope you liked this video. Please give me a thumbs up, give me a like, and if you want to get the pattern for me, send me a message, leave me a message on this YouTube channel. It helps promote WealthLab and this strategy. Thanks a lot. Talk to you then. Bye.